tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. Camden's body was found nearly a week ago in South Berwick. Prosecutors say his mother, Julianne McQuarrie from Texas, killed the six-year-old and then dumped his body here in Maine. She is now in a jail cell in New Hampshire, waiting for her next court appearance on second-degree murder charges next week. Meantime, funeral preparations are underway for Camden tonight. News 8's Keith Baldi is live from Richmond with our continuing coverage. Keith?
Well, Tracy, Camden Hughes' remains are here at this funeral home tonight in Richmond. Today, his grandmother said that his funeral will be held next week in Texas. She also said today that she's shocked by what happened.
As the hearse carrying the remains of six-year-old Camden Hughes pulled into this funeral home in Richmond, Maine, Lou Ray McQuarrie was speaking out in Curtis, Nebraska about the loss of her grandson and the arrest of her daughter for murdering him.
I think it's unbelievable, devastating, heartbreaking. I just can't believe any of this has happened.
Lou Ray says she spoke with her daughter in the days after Camden's death, but before Julianne McQuarrie was arrested. She says everything seemed okay, however, she soon learned it was not.
And to know that I not only lost a grandson, but I feel I've lost a daughter too, in the way that she was.
Lou Ray McQuarrie says she has no idea why Julianne drove to New Hampshire in the first place and did not know she and Camden were going. Lorraine says Julianne lost her job about a month ago and was short on money after buying a mobile home, and perhaps because she was down on her luck, she thought Camden would be taken away, something she did not want to happen.
And I think she was at the end of a rope. And by killing Camden, that would prevent him from living with anyone else.
What were you doing in New England, Julianne?
Lorraine McQuarrie says she has no plans on visiting her daughter in jail in Massachusetts, but she does plan on going to Camden's funeral next week. We're live in Richmond, Keith Baldi, News 8.